Hi there, Doug Stuman with IT Creations. Today we have the 2U Dell EMC PowerEdge C6400 chassis with four dual socket C6420 server nodes. As you'll see in just a moment, this is a high density server node designed for high performance, hyperscale workloads, you know, like financial modeling, high frequency trading, data analytics, hyper-converged infrastructures, software defined storage, and a host of other applications that require ultra fast solutions. This server is designed for large enterprise businesses and data center applications. Let's take a look. What's new on the C6420? For one, those Intel Scalable processors. But in this case, we're also including those that have native support for Intel's OmniPath fabric for even greater scalability and performance. Advanced management tools with intelligent automation designed to improve performance and free up more time for your IT staff to address other business-related opportunities for growth, and a cyber-resilient architecture levering built-in features designed to ensure the security of your system from beginning to end of life. And there's more, but we'll get to that. The 2U C64 chassis is the foundational support for up to four hot swap Dell EMC 6420 compute sleds and provides the storage, power, cooling, and management. The compute sleds do the work of processing and I/O. The combination is designed for dynamic scale-out when used in high-performance, hyperscale workloads. It also supports a factory-integrated liquid cooling solution that can improve energy efficiency by up to 50%. Very impressive when you consider that savings across thousands of servers. By the way, IT Creations carries the Dell C6400 chassis and C6420 server node. For a limited time, you can save up to $250 off the list price of a system valued at $2,500 or more. Just click this link to see pricing on the system or visit IT Creations to see other great deals on servers, workstations, and components. Let's check out the storage on this system. There are five basic chassis configurations to choose from, depending on your application. A 24-bay 2.5-inch chassis with six storage devices allocated to each server node, another 24-bay 2.5-inch chassis that supports up to 16 HDDs or SSDs and eight NVMe drives, again equally distributed, so each node gets two SAS or SATA NVMe drives, along with four SAS or SATA HDDs or SSDs. A two-server node 24-bay configuration allocates 12 drives to each of the two server nodes. Then there's the 3.5-inch version with 12 front-mounted drives where each of the four compute sleds gets three drives. The 3.5-inch chassis does not support NVMe. Lastly, there's a version with no hard drive backplane utilizing the server nodes strictly for compute. A universal backplane supports mixed drives including SAS, SATA, nearline SAS, and self-encrypting drives, both HDDs and SSDs. An NVMe backplane is required to support the NVMe configuration, but can also be used for SAS and SATA HDDs and SSDs. The backplane expander board is only available with the 24-bay 2.5-inch chassis with NVMe configuration and is used for higher single-volume hard drive configurations. However, the SAS expander board works only with a PERC card, like the PERC H330 we have here, and is not supported by the integrated SATA controller. A PCIe add-in adapter card is also required to support the NVMe drives. Located right behind the backplane is a row of four dual rotor fan modules, and behind the fans, nestled between the server sleds, is the chassis management board, providing a management interface to the server sleds. This system easily integrates with VMware vSphere, Microsoft System Center, and Nagios. Each sled features a baseboard management controller, iDRAC 9 with lifecycle controller, and Redfish API for advanced automation management and scripting support. Dell OpenManage can also help you configure and deploy bare metal servers in support of rapid scale-out. An optional M.2 riser can be installed on each of the compute nodes in the x16 PCIe slot 5 for super fast boot. They call this a buried riser probably because it's easy to miss. I'm going to have to assume they're still editing the specs on this system because no mention is made for a second M.2 that can be installed on the other side of the buried PCI riser for slot 5. However, RAID is mentioned, so let's assume you can load two drives in a RAID 1 configuration for fail-safe OS support, either from the integrated SATA controller or an optional controller card. One optional SDHD card with up to 64 gigabytes can be installed on each PCIe riser on each compute sled, offering reliable and inexpensive OS support for your server blade. You can install one or two Intel Scalable processors from the Bronze, Silver, Gold, or Platinum families, including top-of-the-line Platinum 8180 processors with up to 28 cores and a thermal design point of 205 watts. However, CPU thermal restrictions will impact server storage configurations. That said, a liquid cooling solution will enable support for more storage and performance. There are also specific heat sinks for each of the CPUs. As mentioned earlier, OmniPath Scalable processors can also be installed. Skylake F, also known as the OmniPath Scalable processors, have an integrated OmniPath fabric connection. These processors are easily identified by the F after the model number and the x16 connector extension on one side of the processor. The plastic CPU bracket has a cutout on one side for the connector extension on the CPU. The socket for the OmniPath fabric solution is also somewhat different, with two metal tabs designed to support the OmniPath fabric cable. The connection brings the supported PCI lanes up from 48 on standard scalable CPUs to 64 PCI lanes when you add in the direct connection to the CPU. Fabric processors can be installed in a dual or mixed CPU configuration with a standard scalable processor. With two fabric processors installed, a cable will connect directly to each of the processors. With a mixed configuration, the fabric processors must be installed in CPU socket 2 with a cable connecting to the second socket on the OmniPath or Open Compute Project card. At this point, you may be asking yourself, OmniPath? Open Compute Project card? Wait, what? OmniPath removes the extra hardware, like a host device that plugs into a PCI bus. Instead, a fabric interface is integrated directly into the processor architecture, thereby improving performance, power efficiency, and reducing cost by removing the extra hardware. OmniPath architecture also enables greater switch density, requiring less space, less power, and fewer cables for reducing operating costs. Intel says this is better than InfiniBand because of traffic flow optimizations designed to prioritize data at the switch. The system can also handle more requests compared to InfiniBand. And I should mention, there is a dedicated slot on the back of the system for an OmniPath or Open Compute Project card. The Open Compute Project module features one or two ports and uses the direct connection to the CPU, just like OmniPath. The OCP setup, like OmniPath, also provides less latency than InfiniBand and enables greater server density when used with OCP switches. The OCP and OmniPath fabric cards both support 100 gigabit Ethernet, but there are other network cards and connection speeds available, including 1, 10, 25, 40, and 100 gigabit NICs, including InfiniBand. Each processor controls 8 memory modules for a total of 16 active memory slots in a two-processor configuration. You can choose from registered or load-reduced DIMM modules for a maximum capacity of 2 terabytes with both processors installed, or up to 1 terabyte with a single processor. Dell also slyly mentioned support for Intel 3D XPoint memory modules, almost as an afterthought in the technical guide, but no mention in the owner's manual. Oh wait, you haven't heard of those? Intel 3D XPoint DIMMs are non-volatile memory modules that use the same non-volatile memory cores as found in their Optane SSDs. I've also seen these called Optane DIMMs. They promise a much denser implementation of persistent memory and speed compared to NVDIMM-N modules, but may require a new scalable processor, codenamed Cascade Lake. These will be an excellent alternative to in-memory database applications like SAP HANA. More on that when there actually is more. The small plastic baffle between the two processors serves a dual function. Not only does it direct fresh air over the memory and processors, a square notch on top supports a PERC battery for a high-performance RAID controller like the H730P. All the older RAID controllers are supported, including the H730P I just mentioned and the non-RAID HBA330 and the H330 RAID controller we have here. At this point, I was asking myself why the newer and higher-performing Gen 10 HD RAID controllers are not mentioned. I anticipate support for the newer Gen 10 HD RAID controllers like the H740P and the H840, but until then, we'll just be guessing. The servers on the front of the system have an on-off button and status light for each of the server nodes. Pressing and holding the information status button will also give you direct access to system BIOS. The back of the system features an additional on-off switch, two USB 3.0 ports, and a micro USB port for iDRAC Direct. PCI slots 1 through 4 are active with one CPU installed, and PCI slot 5 dedicated for M.2 support is activated with the addition of the second CPU. Powering the system is either a 1600 watt, 2000 watt, or 2400 watt redundant AC power supply. However, when connected to a low-line 100 to 120 volt AC outlet, the power rating is about half. Well, that's hardly it where this platform is concerned, but we will have to see how this story turns out in a few months, with the addition of the Cascade Lake CPUs, 3D XPoint non-volatile memory modules, and perhaps new RAID controllers. If your business demands rapid scale-out architecture, then the C6420 won't let you down and offers serious density and performance. If you have any questions on this platform, and I'm sure there are many, just post them in the comments section below. I've also added a few links to the specifications, and here's a link to the pricing on this system if it looks like you simply have to have it. I mean, it's not suede, but what the hell. Like, share, and comment, especially that share part. I'm Doug Stuman with IT Creations, and thanks for watching.